there's already skepticism. Before the video was released to the public, there were already a lot of skeptics, and we can't really blame them. There are so many strange videos on the internet, and whether it's ghosts, demons, mysterious sea creatures, or mermaid sightings, you have to always go into these videos with a little bit of skepticism, because a lot of these videos turn out to be the work of fiction. Today, it's easier than ever to edit a video together to make something look genuinely real, but that doesn't mean that this video, in fact, is fake. That's up to you to decide. Also, a lot of people have their minds made up about mermaids in general. Who are we to say that mermaids don't exist anywhere? We can't for 100% certainty say that there aren't human-like sea creatures floating around, especially when there's so much of the sea we have yet to explore. Maybe this video has a simple explanation, but there are so many things about the video that add up and make this seem plausible. This is something for you to decide, and it's up to you to determine what's reality and what's fiction. The strange mermaid sighting. So the idea of a mermaid seems strange straight from the get-go. It's a half-fish creature and a half-human creature, kind of like a centaur but with an aquatic tail on the lower half of their body. The upper portion of their body remains that of a human. Wherever there's sea, there is always the mystery of the mermaid and if they really exist. There have been sightings all over the world throughout history, but none of them could ever be proven without a doubt. The video in question was recorded in 2010 and was recently re-uploaded again to get the people who believe back on track and to get the skeptics all fired up. This video was supposedly filmed at the Great Barrier Reef. The video isn't too clear, as most videos shot underwater in 2010 weren't, but it appears to show what it looks like a very vivid mermaid creature swimming away. Some people are 100% convinced that it's the most clear evidence and footage of a mermaid ever recorded. However, the skeptics think it's just a professional swimmer in a costume and they're trying to make a viral video. We may never know the truth behind this video. Why some believe it's real. Others who aren't jumping to conclusions say that this is 100% proof that mermaids are real, which just feels like jumping to different conclusions. Why do they think this 100% without a doubt proves mermaids are real? Well, we have to be honest here. Some people might be reaching just a little bit too much. The first thing people jump to is the fact that the creature in question isn't using their arms to swim and is only using their legs. This is something that professional swimmers can do, and it helps them rest their energy for when they need an extra boost or to use their arms. Also, people have been commenting on how the action of the tail is rather smooth and it's fluid-like, so it doesn't look animated. This one does seem rather solid, and the action of the tail is very smooth. The movement of the arms as the mermaid is floating above the cameraman does look a bit strange, and at one point you can see the arm flailing. Now, the quality of the video is a little too blurry and a little too murky to tell exactly what's going on, but you can clearly see that it definitely does not look human. This could just be the quality of the video, though. Do you think this is evidence of a real mermaid? It's best if we don't prove their existence. One user commented that it's probably best if we never actually prove their existence, because they would more than likely be hunted down and exploited. This is probably true to an extent. To the same extent that we should probably never actually encounter alien life, because who knows what kind of species we could provoke, and you just know the government would want to capture it and run some tests on the being. You've probably seen the hundreds of online videos of mermaids being sighted on the beach or mermaids being seen, but they all turn out to be hoaxes. This featured video of the mermaid sighting in Australia is even published by a channel named Marginal Media Productions, so immediately that is a red flag. With so many burning questions, and if mermaids do exist, it would honestly probably be best if we never actually found a mermaid. We'd have the government and hunters trying to hunt them down for personal gain and profit. It's a sad reality, but you know that's exactly what would happen. Instead of trying to understand more about them, they would become breeding grounds for a new style of hunting and profit. Emperor Augustus. A long time ago, they weren't called mermaids, nor did anyone know anything about them. Today, they've been popularized by the old Disney classic, The Little Mermaid. but long before we had access to social media and pop culture that popularized mermaids, they went by a different name. There was a man by the name of Pliny the Elder, and he wrote an old tale that described mermaids to an exact degree. He described half-human creatures that appeared to be half-fish and appeared to be excellent swimmers. He called these creatures nereids because no one knew what to call them and no one knew exactly where they came from. A lot of people probably thought he was just making them up. He claims that Emperor Augustus actually had a military officer who claims to have seen them in person. He claims that this officer said there was a huge pile of dead nereid corpses on the shore. Do you think there's any truth to this story? The Zimbabwe Incident. Around 2012, there were different construction crews that were working on building dams. However, the project came to a sudden halt and they abandoned the project altogether, with officials looking for answers, presumably wondering why a bunch of people suddenly walked off the job. The construction workers finally gave a chilling answer. Now, we don't know if the workers were allowed to drink on the job, but they seemed to give a pretty convincing answer and seemed pretty stressed out over the incident. According to the locals, they weren't called mermaids. They were known more popularly as Mamba Muntu. They claimed that the mermaids weren't happy with their presence there, and they weren't happy that they were building a dam in their location. These weren't friendly mermaids either, and the construction crews didn't feel safe because the mermaids were viciously harassing them and they couldn't work on the dam anymore. No one knows if there's any truth to this story or not, but it's pretty terrifying to think you'd be getting harassed by a half-fish and half-human. Christopher Columbus. When Christopher Columbus was traveling the world, there was one popular passage he wrote down in 1493. He claims to have encountered three different mermaids and that they suddenly rose out of the sea when he wasn't very far off the coast of Haiti. Christopher Columbus documented much of his travels, and he always had his journal nearby to document things that seemed rather strange or out of place. One of the most bizarre things about his claims of seeing mermaids wasn't exactly the sighting, but it was how he described them. He said that they weren't beautiful at all when they rose out of the sea, and they're nothing like you'd expect them to look. He said their faces were intense, they were ugly, and their faces had very masculine features, so I guess he was saying they looked more like men or creatures than they did beautiful women. However, being alone that long at sea with as much alcohol that was on those ships, it's hard to know how much of his journal was truth and how much was the alcoholic ramblings of an adventurer. The Sick Mermaid. Around the year 1430, there's a story in the Netherlands that supposedly says that a group of young girls who were out and about walking along the coast suddenly spotted a mermaid that was having trouble. This is one of many reports we've heard of mermaids in the 1400s, and we have to wonder if there's a reason that so many of these sightings came from the 1400s. According to this group of girls, when they saw the girl, they could see she was sick. They pulled her to the shore, according to the group, and then they dressed her up in clothing. One of the main problems we have with this story is there's not a lot of definitive details about what happened next or whatever came of this story. What happened after they dressed up the mermaid in clothing? Did they alert anyone? Did the mermaid swim back into the water? There's really not a lot to go on for this story, but there's definitely something to be had with the 1400s and mermaid sightings. Pendine whales. On the unfamiliar waters of Wales during 1603, one of the last things you'd expect to see is a sea creature suddenly rise out of the water. However, that's exactly what happened to a farmer named Thomas Reynold. Reynold was doing his normal duties as he did every single day, and when he took notice to the shore, he noticed that a strange-looking creature began to rise out of the water. The farmer took a good, long look at the mystifying creature and didn't know what he was looking at. He later described it as a half-female and half-fish and said it looked monstrous. It had a very peculiar face, and it also didn't look very womanly, as Christopher Columbus also described when he saw his first mermaid sighting. We have to imagine that creatures who spend all day in the sea and don't exactly have access to skincare probably aren't gonna look that beautiful. The 2014 Mermaid Corpse. Now, take this one with a grain of salt, because a lot of people think it was a hoax, but some people swear it was real. In 2014, there was a body with aquatic features that washed up on the shores of New Zealand. This creature caused a lot of controversy and went viral almost immediately. It was also a humanoid creature, and it was a dead corpse, but no one could say for sure how the body died. No one could also say whether it was real or not, because this could easily have been a hoax. It wouldn't take a lot of money to create a dummy that looks like this and put it on the beach to get people riled up. If you look at the picture, you can also see that this mermaid has a lot of sharp teeth, unlike humans, but there's definitely a lot of humanoid features aside from the scales and the weird dread hair. Do you think mermaids are real? Do you think the encounters were imaginations of the mind? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.